Kitchen Go. Today, I'm going to be doing some work. I'm going to take you guys to my favorite cafe in Seoul. It's super quiet inside. You're not even allowed to take pictures in there. You get really self-conscious using your mouse because it's so quiet. And there's a lot of people sharing that room. So the cafe is called May Island Coffee and Library. It's actually quieter than a library. And it's a couple stories high. And it's located across from Bibigo and Tea Purple. And, well, the surroundings can change. To get to this May Island Cafe, take exit 11 from the Gangnam Station. Then turn your first right onto Gangnam-daero 96Q. Then take the first left onto Taehyeon-no 1Q. May Island Cafe will be on your left. May Island Cafe also has a second location near the Apgujeong Station. So we gotta take an elevator up. Don't bring in food, don't use your phone, no loving, dubbing, and no talking. Alrighty, we're first gonna go here to order our drinks. And I got my chamomile tea. So you could study here on the fourth floor, but I'm gonna go to the fifth floor because they have a bigger space and it's much nicer. And there's a lot of seating options. Inside, I can't talk, so I'm gonna give you like a very quiet tour just to walk through, and I'll add a voiceover. The space is designed to make studying fun and inspiring. Because there's a diversity in seating arrangements, no matter how many times you come, it doesn't get boring too fast. The first time I came to May Island, I sat in one of the circular spaces next to the window where you take off your shoes. If you need a break from studies, check out the bookshelf for inspiration. Wherever you sit, there is an electrical outlet waiting for your plug. The second time I came to May Island Cafe, I sat inside a floating box, raised about 3 feet from the ground. Once again, take off your shoes before entering. I don't understand why this enclosed space isn't more popular than it is. It's the best place to be. I feel like a princess just breathing the air in here. Now I'm going to give you a tour of the back alley. The booths lined up against the wall are always occupied whenever I come to this cafe. Pray to the lucky star to score one. Otherwise, there's a space available elsewhere. Even during the cafe's peak hours, you'll likely find a seat. And if you come all by yourself, you'll feel secure leaving your stuff temporarily to use the bathroom or go out for a ciggy break. Look up at the ceiling and there are tons of CCTV cameras. In the many hours I've worked at May Island, not once did I hear anyone speak even one word. It's that quiet. It's so quiet that even if you're a professional silent farter, your guests will be scared to come out. While most cafes I've been to in Korea have one Wi-Fi network, May Island Cafe has 8! So you could depend on being able to surf the web as much as your heart desires, without worrying connection going down. If Wi-Fi number one goes down, you got 7 backups. Alrighty, so it was a very productive cafe session, working on videos and whatnot. I just posted a KWOW, and I did some vlogging for my website. Now it's time to go home to my grandma's house and eat dinner with her. She always waits for me, she doesn't eat until I come home. I'll see you guys in the next episode of KWOW. Three in a bed, aka threesome. Look at how it crawls. Oh my god!
Okay.
This right here is sausage wrapped with fish cake. And those are little mini kimbap, fried kimbap, and odeng, fish cakes, tteokbokki, sundae. You order your food and they give you a plate and you just stand and eat here.